MEPO has been in place for about 5 years. 2008 was the very first MEPO program.
My name is Taylor Mitchum. I'm a senior in mining engineering, and I did MEPO in 2008. I've seen a huge progression since the first MEPO in 2008. It's amazing the improvements that we do every year.
We've seen in the last 5 years is that, for starters, students who did it in the first years are now PAs for multiple years. So it's very helpful where students see other students who are benefited by MEPO.
My name is Edgar Lopez. I am a senior in industrial engineering, and I did MEPO in 2009. I made long-lasting friendships. Some of them I see, in my classes. They're still doing engineering, which is great. And even the mentors that I had, they graduated in engineering, and they definitely were a good influence during their 4 years here at Penn State.
The other thing that we see is that in 5 years, the mentoring has really begun to pay off. And we find that students who do MEPO, they get more resource information, they get more more support information and regarding how to be successful as an engineer.
I.O. Battles-Williams, civil engineering, junior year. And I was a participant in the 2010 MEPO. It would have been a much harder journey to get where I am now than necessary. The homeworks were hard, and the resources definitely helped me.
The retention numbers will go up, or are beginning to go up, because MEPO is here.
My name is David Robert. I am an industrial engineering major, currently a sophomore at this moment. I did MEPO 2011, which was last year, and so I had to come back this year and give back and try to help out.
Mario Stone, and this is MEPO 2012.
My favorite thing I've probably done so far today,
all right,
or just in general, it would probably be the icebreaker game we played when we first came here, like acting out the skills, because I enjoyed performing, and plus the, all the other icebreaker games, getting to know everybody. It was really fun in the long run.
There's a lot of teamwork going on here right now. Some people are blindfolded, they have to listen to the voices, they have project managers, safety, and they're basically putting kids together. They're building a movement from the ground up, and it's quite interesting when you walk around and listen to how well people listen and how well they're working together.
We get along.
Yeah, this is 4.
No. 4.
4B.
4B.
Represent.
Every time I fell for you, I'm permanently black and blue. Permanently blue for you.
3.
No.
Okay.
Do headstands for you. I tried to do headstands for you.
right now, the budget of Amazing Race, gotta go from behind the Hammond to Leonard Building to Old Main to Forum. Then they gotta go to Eisenhower Auditorium, to the Creamery, and finally to the Beaver Stadium. So
it was a great competition for all the teams. I mean, we all have different strengths. I mean, the hardest part was like the math problem, which was unexpected because we were thinking that we was more physical than intellectual. But I mean, we pulled through with hard work and dedication.
I think it's a great way to get us started, and especially with the project, we actually get a chance to design something, and that'll really help us a lot in the future.
The event is basically them to build a wind turbine and also create a generator which will power the light emitting diodes inside of a Barbie doll house, which is a two-story Barbie doll house filled with light emitting diodes.
Yeah. We're going to make the windmill with the blades on this side and have the generator and motor running on this side, and it's supposed to spin, and then we make electricity.
If you could describe MEPO in one word, what word would it be?
One word. I mean, informational.
Fantastic.
Diverse.
Fun.
Broomball.
I would say active.
Resourceful.
Teamwork. Yeah, basically teamwork.
Catalyst.
I would say successful.
Stupendous.
Community. Engineering community.